continue with thermal analysis. Today we will discuss about the last thermoanalytical technique, that is thermometric titration. Already we discussed the various thermogrammetric analysis, TGA, differential thermal analysis, DTA, differential scanning calorimetry, DSC, dynamic mechanical analysis, DMA, thermomechanical analysis, TMA, and today we will discuss detail about the thermometric titration, that is TT. Let's discuss about the background of the TT, mean thermometric titration. Each chemical reaction involves an enthalpy change that leads to change in temperature. What is the enthalpy change? Basically, the enthalpy change is also known as enthalpy of the reaction. And the enthalpy of reaction is a change in enthalpy of a chemical reaction that occurs at constant pressure. It is thermodynamical unit of the measurement useful for calculating the amount of energy per mole either released or produced in a chemical reaction. So the amount of substance converted during the reaction determines the increase mean exothermic reaction or decrease, that is the endothermic reaction, in temperature. In thermometric titration, the rigid solution mean titrant is added to the sample at a constant rate until attaining the end point. So this is the same type of simple titration that is done without any type of heating. At the normal temperature, this is the same type of titration, but in this we will measure change of temperature by the action of titrant and titrand. So let us go through the principle of TT. The titrant is added at a known constant rate to the titrand until the completion of the reaction is indicated by change in temperature. The end point is determined by an inflection in the curve generated by the output of temperature measuring devices. Basically, the temperature change during the reaction of titrant and titrand will be measured by using a suitable device. So, in this titration, the addition of a device when we compare it with the normal type of titration. In thermometric titration, make use of heat of reaction to obtain titration curves. The heat of reaction is same as the enthalpy change of the reaction. In usual practice, the temperature of solution is plotted against the volume of titrant. TT is performed by allowing the titrant to flow from a thermostated burette directly into solution contained in a thermally insulated vessel, mean the vessel contained the titrant. Subsequently, the observed change in temperature of solution is recorded precisely either during continuous addition of titrant or after every successive incremental addition. The endpoint is aptly indicated by sharp break in the curve. As the dielectric constant of a solvent exerts little effect on the thermometric titration, the latter may be employed effectively in most non-aqueous media. Hence, in broader sense, TT may be utilized in a number of reactions with great efficacy. For instance, complexation. Complex means the complexometric titration can be observed by thermometric by TT analysis, precipitation titration, redox titration, and neutralization titration. In complexometric titration means that there is a complexation form between EDT and any type of metal that make the complex. Precipitation titration usually involves the column in type of argentometric titration, where silver nitrate is involved, the precipitate of silver chloride is formed. Redox titration in which oxidation reduction reactions occur, usually KMnO4 and potassium perchlorate is used. Neutralization titration is a simple type of titration in which acid base are involved. TT can be used to titrate gas against other gases devoid of a liquid phase and to titrate liquid solution with the gaseous reagents. As the temperature sensor thermoprobe has a 0.3 second response time and at a 10^-5 Kelvin resolution, the high resolution titration, even minute changes in enthalpy can be monitored reliably. So this is the advantage of DT over the manual type of titrations. Following are the most salient advantage of thermometric titration. Results can be obtained rapidly. Solves the issue of titrating difficult samples that cannot be titrated potentiometrically. Potentiometrically titration are those titration in which EMF of reaction mixture is measured as a result of reaction of titrant and titrant. Robust technique for routine work and highly suitable for aggressive media. Robustness is basically usually a terminology used in analytical chemistry. A robust test is designed to show the reliability of method response as different are varied when there are different steps in a particular type of technique are varied, but the results will be reliable with good accuracy and precision. This is called the robustness of any analytical method. The temperature changes observed during a thermometric titration are the consequence of the heat evolved or absorbed. Mean either it's the exothermic reaction or the endothermic reaction. By the reaction between the analyte and the reagent, the heat or enthalpy of reaction delta H is given by the familiar thermodynamic expression. The probe remains in a contact with the sample and move upward or downward as the sample length. In this case, the sample thickness changes with temperature, that is delta H is equal to delta G plus T delta S, where T is temperature, delta G is free energy change, and delta is the entropy change of the reaction. Entropy change means the disorderness of the system. The change in the temperature delta T during thermometric titration is given by delta T is equal to minus N delta H over K, where N is the number of moles of the reactant and K is the heat capacity of the system. Everywhere you will find in TT the heat capacity, that is the enthalpy change of the reaction during the reaction of titrant and titrand. Thus, the total change in the temperature is directly proportional to the number of moles of the analyte. For ideal conditions in TT, heat losses are gained from outside the system via the vessel walls and cover. Differences in the temperature between the titrant and the titrand. Evaporative losses from the surface of the rapidly mixed fluids. Heat of solution when the titrant solvent is mixed with analyte solvent. Heat introduced by the mechanical reaction of the stirring, that is mirror influence. Heat produced by the thermistor itself, a very minor influence. Thermistor is the sensor that is used in TT. So from the graph you can easily see, you can find the end point of any type of titration, that is the response along the x-axis is ml of the titrant, while along the y-axis is the solution temperature. So there is a direct relationship between the temperature and ml use of the titrant, and there is steep changes in the curve defined resulted the end point of any type of titration that is doing by TT. For experiment, consider the titration reaction A plus B is equal to P. Let A represent the titrant and B the titrant. Small a, small b, and small p are the number of the moles. At the beginning of the titration, the titrant B is strongly in excess and the reaction is pushed toward the completion. Under these conditions, for a constant rate of titrant addition, the temperature increases is constant and the curve is essentially linear until the endpoint is approached, as you see on the last slide. In a similar manner, when the titrant is in excess past the endpoint, a linear temperature response can also be anticipated. Thus, intersection of titrant will reveal the true endpoint of any type of completion of the reaction that is doing by TT. This is a thermistor figure. Thermistor, the most practical sensor for measuring temperature change in titrating solution, has been found to be the thermistor. Thermistors are small solid state devices which exhibit relatively large changes in electrical resistance for small changes in temperature. It is capable of solving temperature changes as low as 10 raised to power minus 5 K, it's mean this sense a very minute changes between the minute changes occurred between the reaction of titrant and titrant and it observed at the 10 raised to power minus 5 Kelvin. So let's see about the instrumentation of TT. A standard thermometric titration assembly essentially consists of the following four vital components, mainly motor driven burette, adiabatic titration chamber, thermistor bridge assembly, and recorder. Continue with the instrumentation figure. This figure shows the represent the schematic thermometric titration assembly complete with the bridge circuit at the right side of the figure. To minimize heat transfer losses from the solution by its immediately surrounding, the thermometric titrations are usually carried out in an isolated beaker tightly closed with a stopper having provision from a burette tape, a motorized glass stirrer, and a temperature monitoring arrangement. You can see in the figure there is a titrant at the top, water jacket, motorized stirrer, terminal for thermistors, thermistor, block of the styrofoam that is for heat use as heat sink, insulated beaker that is inserted in the block of the styrofoam. Now let's see the procedure of the TT. Introduce the titrant from a burette that is duly mounted in a thermostated water jacket to maintain the temperature of the titrant within plus minus 0.05 degrees. Such a great accuracy is achieved by TT. Experimental parameters are predetermined in such a fashion such that the volume of titrant needed for each titration must lie between 1.123 mL. Procedure continue. Automated device delivering reagent at a steady and constant rate of 600 microliter per minute usually permits recording. Constant speed motorized stirrer at 600 RPM is employed to effect uniform mixing of the solution. Variation in temperature are measured with the help of a sensitive thermistor sensing element with fast response that is sealed completely in glass and immersed in a solution. Procedure is continued in the course of a thermometric titration. The thermistor attached to the insulated beaker is constant to one arm of the Wheatstone bridge as displayed in figure that was displayed in the last slide. The values of the circuit component listed are for a thermistor having an approximate resistance of 2 kilo ohm and a sensitivity of minus 0.04 ohm per ohm per centimeter in the 25 degree centigrade temperature range. Hence, an observed change of 1 degree centigrade, an unbalanced potential of 15.5 millivolt, and the heat of reaction is either absorbed or generated upon the addition of titrant to the beaker, thereby unbalancing the Wheatstone bridge caused by the simultaneous variation in the resistance, mean temperature in the insulated beaker. Thus, the bridge unbalanced potential is promptly plotted by the recorder. So this measured the temperature against the volume of the titrant in TT. So there is a directly proportional relationship between the volume of the titrant and the change in the temperature. So the plotter against between these two parameter give the sharp endpoint of any type of titration that is doing by TT technique. There must be a precaution during the titration, thermometric titration, to minimize the temperature variation between the titrant and the solution and also to obviate volume correction. The concentration of the titrant is invariably maintained 10 to 100 times higher than that of the reactant. To obtain optimum results, temperature of the titrant and the solution must be always within 0.2 degree centigrade of each other before a titration is commenced. So, what is the methodology involved in TT? In thermometric titration, curves usually represented both the entropy and the free energy involved. The titrant is added to the solution at a constant rate in order that the voltage output of the thermistor temperature transducer changes linearly with the time up to the equivalence point. Equivalence point means the end point. The TT method affords exact endpoint due to colored solutions, poisoning of electrodes. These are the limitations of the other type of titrations, and this is the advantage of TT. Lower limit of concentration which can be titrated effectively as 0.002 molar, mean up to 2 millimole concentration can be titrated with TET thermoanalytical technique. No transfer of heat between the titration vessel and its immediate surrounding is allowed. This is an example. For example, in usual practice, it has been observed that the thermometric titration are mostly feasible with such systems that provide rate of temperature changes more than 0.01 degree per second. For example, we have a titrant sodium hydroxide and the solution is HCl. This is a simple type of titration, mean the neutralization titration, that is also called the acid-based titration. By acid-based titration, there is a change of temperature when the reaction of acid and bases occurred as a result of salt formation. So temperature changes to plus 0.4 degree, that is easily heard by TT. Second one is the EDTA titrant, means sodium EDTA 1 molar against the solution of that is titrant magnesium chloride 0.033 molar, and the change of temperature is minus 0.08 degree centigrade. And this is a complexometric type of titration. As a result of TT, we get a thermometric titration curve. This is clearly shown from the figure, that again the graphical explanation of TT, that the volume of titrant and the temperature. At the start, the titration branch, that is excess of titrant branch. So the tangent line dot between two straight lines, and the center point of these two tangent lines is the end point or the equivalent point. An acid based reaction is exothermics, which means we can follow the titration by monitoring the titration mixture temperature as a function of volume of titrant added. A typical thermometric titration curve is shown here. Prior to equivalence point, the increase in temperature results from the reaction between the titrant and the titrant. After the equivalence point, the increase in temperature is due to the dissolution of the titrant, typical strong acid or a strong base in water. Now we discuss about the applications of the TT. Various important applications of thermometric titration are enumerated below. For example, the benzene in cyclohexane. Benzene, a very toxic compound that up to 2 ppm it is carcinogenic. Benzene may be estimated rapidly with fairly good accuracy in cyclohexane by measuring the heat of nitration, whereby a previously prepared standard nitrating acid mixture benzene and cyclohexane and a subsequent temperature rise is noted, which is direct function of the quantity of benzene present. So, for the determination of benzene and cyclohexane, this the material required. Thermometric titration assembly as per figure, minus the burette, a stopwatch or the timer, a standard nitrating acid mixture that is mixed to volume of 70% nitric acid that should have a density of 1.41 with one volume of 95% H2SO4 with density of 1.82 gram per cc. Bakelite screw cap bottle that over capacity 4 ounce. So let's see the procedure for the determination of benzene in the cyclohexane. Weigh exactly the 50 gram of sample in bakelite screw cap bottle, and in a similar bottle put the standard nitrating mixture. Place these two bottles in a thermostat maintained at 20 degree centigrade and the content have attained an equilibrium temperature. Transfer 50 ml of standard nitrating acid to the insulated vessel and insert the motorized stirrer. Just wait for about 3 to 5 minutes and then start the motorized stirrer. After exactly 1 minute, record the initial temperature. Stop the motor, insert the sample into the reaction vessel and start the stirring. Now start taking reading the rise in temperature after each interval of 1, 2, 3 and 5 minutes respectively. Plot a calibration curve between the observed temperature rise in the 3 minutes interval versus the percentage benzene present in the cyclohexane. Run pure cyclohexane and standard containing 0.5 to 5% benzene biphate. So another application of the TTA, the determination of sodium in various food sample food matrices. Regulatory agencies and consumers are working harder for the precise analysis of sodium content in food products. Direct measurement techniques such as inductively coupled plasma spectroscopy ICP and atomic absorption spectroscopy AAS are the quite expensive and time consuming for testing in the labs. As a result, a number of food companies indirectly analyze sodium by using the analysis result of the chloride. Indirectly measure chloride that converts to as sodium chloride. Subsequently, the sodium content is typically calculated by presuming that the molar ratio of chloride ion to sodium ion in the food is 1:1. However, this is not necessarily the case, especially when there is the presence of chloride-containing ingredient like potassium chloride. Are common sodium-containing food ingredients like monosodium glutamate and sodium benzoate in the food matrices, then how we determine the sodium and its direct contact with the chloride, and we determine the amount of sodium relative to chloride, then it will be very tedious and difficult. When there is also a source of chloride present and also the source of sodium present in the food matrices. In this, monosodium glutamate is a type of flavor, and sodium benzoate is usually used as preservative in the foods. The food is initially homogenized, so the analysis of sodium by TTA is done like this one. The food is initially homogenized using a high frequency homogenizer. Subsequently, ammonium hydrogen difluoride is added to the sample. And then thermometric titration of the sample is carried out using a standardized aluminium solution containing a stoichiometric excess of potassium ions. Insoluble sodium potassium aluminium fluoride is acquired from this exothermic reaction. As a result of exothermic reaction, there is a change in temperature, means the temperature will be rise. So the relationship between the addition, the volume of the titrant and the change of temperature as a result of reaction of titrant and titrant graph will be obtained, and there is a equivalent point will be resulted as a by drawing the tangent line above two lines. Also, see another application: determination of sulfate and phosphate in various fertilizers. Determination of phosphate and sulfate in liquid fertilizers and granular fertilizers such as triple superphosphate TCS, TSP, diammonium phosphate DAP, and monoammonium phosphate MAP. Thermometric titration of sulfate can be carried out in a fast and easy way using a standard barium solution as titrant, because the barium is precipitated the sulfate. That is the most suitable reagent that containing the barium. Usually the barium chloride is used for the precipitation of sulfate with barium as barium sulfate. The process is already in use for determining the sulfate in wet process phosphoric acid. These results are presented as percentage of elemental sulfur, mean the percentage of sulfur. Otherwise, cracks and damages can occur and lead to the product failure. Thermometric titration of phosphate can be performed in a fast and easy way using standard magnesium solution as titrant, because magnesium phosphate is water insoluble, obtained as a result of reaction of phosphate with any type of magnesium containing mean magnesium chloride or magnesium sulfate. This technique for determining titrimetric phosphate based on a classical gravimetric method. The phosphate containing solution is buffered by using ammonium chloride ammonia solution instantly before the titration. Insoluble magnesium ammonium phosphate is formed as a result of again the exothermic reaction. The results are prepared as percentage of P mean phosphorus R and P2O5 phosphorus pentoxide. The amount of phosphoric acid in liquid fertilizers can be thermometrically detected easily using a standardized sodium hydroxide solution having a concentration of 2 mole per liter mean 2 molar concentration solution. The interfering calcium content present in the phosphoric fertilizer can be removed by addition of saturated oxalate solution. In this way, using the TT, we can determine the quality of the various type of fertilizers. So this is all about the TT, mean the thermometric titration. If you have any question, so you can put the question in the chat box. And again, thank you very much.